Item number, SCP-037. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-037 is magnetically contained in a subterranean complex, known as Site-22. Object size, spectral signature, and temperature are constantly monitored both on-site and remotely from Site-98. The primary containment chamber is lined with heat-conducting, radiation-resistant, nanopeak GFV polymer tiles, and evacuated of any atmosphere. Heat from the object is radiated into the surrounding rock. Should enclosure integrity become compromised, the emergency system will generate a low-power argon plasma shield. This is projected to provide a minimum of 4 hours for our on-site engineers to effect necessary repairs before the object breaches containment. In the contingency that stellar evolution proceeds ahead of projections and a Nova event appears imminent, or if containment failure is otherwise unavoidable, any remaining project staff are authorized to initiate the PITUAC protocol. Description: SCP-037 appears to be a star, approximately 5 centimeters or 2 inches in diameter, with a luminosity of about 1 to the power of 10 to 12 times that of our Sun, and a surface temperature of about 5,000 Kelvin, determined by UBVRI analysis. The origin of SCP-037 is unknown. However, analysis suggests that it shares many properties in common with a typical main-sequence star, other than its anomalously small size. It is theorized to have entered the Earth's magnetosphere via the North Magnetic Pole. The object was discovered in 1995 above the Beaufort Sea at approximately the North Magnetic Pole. Intense electromagnetic interference was reported by Canadian Forces Station, CFS Alert, followed by an extremely bright object descending towards the ocean from the sky. The SCPS Guardian responded and discovered the object wavering in an erratic trajectory about 200 meters above the surface of the water. Once containment procedures were devised, it was transported to Site-32 for study. Containment and transport of SCP-037 have been achieved by the use of powerful electromagnets to which the artifact aligns itself according to its own magnetic field. The primary challenge to containment thus far has been its powerful electromagnetic emissions, which are intense enough to be easily seen by the naked eye from high Earth orbit. Its current enclosure is located deep underground to prevent detection and to facilitate radiative cooling into the surrounding bedrock. In effect, the entire facility and the surrounding volume of the Earth's crust act as a massive heat sink. Addendum A. Over the past years of study, the star has undergone a shift in emitted EM radiation, suggesting that it is undergoing stellar evolution at a vastly accelerated rate. If standard stellar models hold up, this will soon result in an increase in radius by a factor of 100 to 300 times, and a concomitant increase in radiated energy. Emergency containment contingencies are being studied for that eventuality. Further progression of the star's life cycle will likely terminate in a stellar nova, which is estimated to have a yield of extrapolations predict this to occur, and research is underway for a method to arrest this development or to transport SCP-037 a safe distance from the planet before it occurs. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-036, The Reincarnation Pilgrimage of the Yazidi, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.